And finally, we're going back to fluid dynamics. Now, physics might not be the lightest topic to finish on, but a problem that physicists have grappled with since 1883 has just been solved, and it is fascinating. The problem is this. You have an S-shaped lawn sprinkler, so an S-shaped pipe on a pivot, and the water squirts out at right angles to the axis and makes it spin in a certain direction. Everybody knows which way it goes round. It backs away from the outgoing water. Now the question is this. If you had a water tank and you submerged the sprinkler completely underwater and sucked the water in instead of pushing it out, which way would it turn? Would it, one, turn in the direction that it does when you push water out into air, or two, would it turn the other way? This riddle of Feynman's sprinkler was popularised by physicist Richard Feynman. The answer is perfectly clear at first sight, he wrote in his memoir. Surely you're joking, Mr. Feynman. The trouble was, some guy would think it was perfectly clear in one direction, and another guy would think it was perfectly clear the other way. The first documented description of this problem is in a textbook, The Science of Mechanics, which was published in 1883. And there the author reported that the device showed no distinct movement at all. In the 1940s, this problem began to circulate among members of the physics department at Princeton University in the USA, and it generated a lively debate. Richard Feynman, who was at the time a young graduate student, gave one theoretical argument for why the sprinkler should rotate in the fault direction, and another one for why it should rotate in reverse. Feynman then built a makeshift experiment in the university's cyclotron laboratory. His experiment ended in an explosion of the glass equipment that he was using. He did not say whether or how the sprinkler actually moved. The complexities of flow and turbulence mean that all past experiments have either been inconclusive or given contradictory results, or in Feynman's case, an explosion, broken glass, and a thorough soaking. However, researchers have now carefully designed a sprinkler to remove all the confounding effects. And the results are in this absolutely gorgeous image. Detailed observations, backed up by mathematical modelling, have demonstrated that there's a weak jet effect inside the device, and that's what dominates the sprinkler's motion. What they've shown is that the underwater sprinkler rotates in the opposite direction to the normal one, but unsteadily and about 50 times slower. It might seem that reversing a submerged sprinkler is not of great practical interest, but there are applications in which it's really important to be able to precisely control flows ejected from devices and to understand how the process modifies the forces they experience. For example, there's lots of application in technologies that harvest energy from the movement of water or air.